Look, right. He's in the Backyard Weather Center just having to deal with that little pond that he's got to swim in.
I absolutely love the beach. I love the mountains in the wintertime. I love going to skiing and snowboarding, but I love the beach too. And the good thing is, so far this spring, it's been kind of on the cool side, so maybe it hasn't been right in front of us. Of course, that does change tomorrow and Saturday, where we're going to have the heat and a little bit of humidity as well, and you might get that itch a little bit more to head to the coast. Let me show you what we've got outside right now. Currently, the temperature 77 degrees, a southwest wind at 13 miles per hour. That wind switched direction a little bit and picked up in speed as the warm front came through the area earlier this afternoon. And other temperatures are in the mid to upper 70s just about everywhere in Virginia, closing in on 80 degrees up toward the Hanover area right now, as well as Tappahannock, and it's already 81 down in Williamsburg. Pollen report for today, both the tree and the grass are in the moderate category. And for tonight, our temperatures, they're not going to drop a whole lot. We're actually going to stay in the 60s for our overnight lows. So if you get out early in the morning to exercise, you might work up a little extra lather than you have over the past several days. Nice shot through our Millionaire Cam. We have partly cloudy skies and just a couple of sprinkles out there, some out in the higher terrain. That's about it. Around the region, we are in what is called the warm sector right now. We're south of the warm front and ahead of the cold front. In this type of pattern, we get the warmth in from the south, and we'll also get a lot of moisture coming up out of the Gulf of Mexico. And that'll set the stage for some thunderstorms by Saturday. Lows tonight will be in the low 60s. High temperatures for tomorrow in the mid 80s. A nice warm day and a breezy day tomorrow to wrap up this week. Already 81 by noon and a high of 86. Southwest winds 15 to 25 miles per hour. Rest of tonight, not much going on across the area, and quiet throughout the day tomorrow with plenty of sunshine. As we get into Saturday, though, things begin to change. Not so much Saturday morning, but by afternoon, a cold front will sink in from the north, and along that front, we'll see converging air. It'll be a kind of a focus for thunderstorms to develop across the area and a good chance for some of that rainfall across central Virginia. Now, this takes us over the next 9 days to show you beyond this weekend. As we get into next week, we may have an upper level low that just kind of sits on top of us, and that keeps the atmosphere very unstable. And this is just one model, but this is the 9-day rainfall total, and it could be a soaker for us here through that stretch. Speaking of soakers, down to the south in the Florida Straits, we have a developing area of low pressure. The track through the weekend is going to take it up north of the Bahamas, where it could become either a depression or possibly a subtropical storm. If it does become a subtropical storm, it would be called Arthur. That is the first name on the list. If you go back to the last time we used Arthur, that was in 2014, and that storm was a hurricane, a Category 2 hurricane, and that occurred over 4th of July weekend. Came right over the Outer Banks, and we were there. There's a look at your 7-day forecast, and dry tomorrow, but after that, boy, things really start to get active. Some thunderstorms Saturday, mostly dry Sunday, but showers and some storms very likely Monday, and much cooler for the middle of next week.